When it comes to implementing crazy ideas, SpaceX has never failed to surprise us. And with their Starship launch tower that could one day catch the Super Heavy boosters out of the air with huge arms, SpaceX could set a new record. Make sure you stick around until the end of the video, because today we're going to take a look at the progress on SpaceX's launch tower, which is designed to catch Starship Booster. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. SpaceX has conducted multiple high-altitude Starship flight tests at Starbase, located in Boca Chica, Texas. Although the Starship has received a lot of attention, the most significant development to reach space will be its Super Heavy booster. Over the past 4 months, four full-size prototypes of the 165-foot-tall, 50-meters Starship spacecraft have launched on high-altitude test flights, each with impressive yet ultimately explosive results. However, the company hadn't showcased any versions of Super Heavy until March the 18th, when Elon Musk posted a photo of the big rocket at the company's South Texas site, near the Gulf Coast village of Boca Chica. His tweet read, "First Super Heavy booster." The main purpose of Super Heavy would be to get off the planet. This is because the Starship is already powerful enough to carry itself off the Moon and Mars. However, due to Earth's massive size and intense gravitational force, we will need an additional force to lift the Starship off the surface, as it won't be able to generate escape velocity on its own. SpaceX approaches things a little differently than other companies. This was evident again in December, when CEO Elon Musk tweeted, "We're going to try to grab the Super Heavy booster with a launch tower arm, using the grid fins to carry the load." Elon Musk had first announced the outlandish Starship booster recovery plan at the end of 2020. However, 3 months later, Elon made an even wilder claim. The same booster-catching tower could also capture Starships. As per Musk, the launch tower could have a second, equally critical function. Musk's tweet in March read, "Might just catch the ship with a launch tower, same as booster." The massive tower may also be used to join the 165-foot spacecraft to its 230-foot rocket. The Starship would be just below 400 feet long with its booster. To put it in perspective, it would be almost 100 feet taller than the Statue of Liberty. Around the time the idea was first floated, SpaceX was starting to build one of two planned towers that could eventually be outfitted with arms. At first, the presence of a self-propelled drill and a few muddy holes in the right spot were the only indications of progress. However, by mid-March, SpaceX had started removing some of the soil on top, exposing a solid foundation consisting of 25 2-foot-thick, 1-meter, piles buried at least 100 feet, 30 meters, deep in the sandy wetlands. 2 weeks later, the foundation had been encased in concrete, and the framework for the huge base was almost ready for its first concrete pour. The first SpaceX launch tower in South Texas has begun to take shape, growing vertically out of the ground like a giant fortress tower. Its ultimate goal is to reduce the mass of the booster and aid rapid reusability. The biggest challenge, as with all rockets, is the mass. For a rocket, the focus is to build the lightest vehicle possible while still achieving maximum efficiency. In theory, it sounds simple. But in practice, containing volatile liquids at high pressures is anything but simple. The dry mass of a Super Heavy is expected to be about 100 metric tons, so the landing legs must be heavy enough to safely land such a heavy object. For instance, the first stage of the Falcon 9 rocket has four large landing legs made of carbon fiber and aluminium that helps to stabilize the spacecraft as it touches down. Although made of light materials, the four landing legs have a total mass of around 2 metric tons. Scaling up the Falcon 9 booster to the size of Super Heavy landing legs would undoubtedly add a significant amount of mass. The legs of the Super Heavy booster are expected to weigh between 5 and 10 metric tons. Thus, by eliminating the landing legs, you not only reduce the mass of the booster, but also reduce the complexity of designing the landing legs. Launch tower seems to be a smart choice, right? Launch tower will also allow SpaceX to achieve its long-held goal of rapid reusability. Elon Musk has always envisioned landing the booster right on the launch pad so that it can be refueled and launched right away. If everything goes as planned, the launch tower would allow the booster to be ready to fly again with a new payload and upper stage, also known as Starship, in under an hour. The goal with Starship and Super Heavy is to build a launch vehicle that is much more reusable than SpaceX's current Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy system. Ultimately, the launch tower would provide a rock-solid base for SpaceX to install Super Heavy boosters on the launch mount, followed by Starships on top of those boosters. Standing at least 122 meters, 395 feet tall, from tip to tail, without even accounting for the launch mount Starship would attach to, the relatively easy task turns out to be anything but simple. Musk tweeted, "We will need a launch tower for that. Hook height for the lift is around 140 meters, and both booster and ship need to be stabilized at stage separation joint." According to Musk, SpaceX's Boca Chica launch tower would have a hook height of at least 140 meters, 460 feet, implying that the crane at the top of the tower would be 150 to 160 meters, 490 to 520 feet tall when configured to attach Starship to Super Heavy. So how do you use a launch tower to catch a flying rocket? The plan would be for the launch tower arm to catch the Super Heavy booster with its grid fins taking the load. The grid fins are a type of flight control surface used on rockets and bombs. Initially, six fins were supposed to function exclusively as fairings to protect the six landing legs and four diamond-shaped welded steel grid fins to provide aerodynamic stability on descent. However, the leg design was later reduced to only four landing legs and fins to improve supersonic engine plume recirculation margins. As I mentioned earlier, the grid fins are going to be made out of steel and will support the weight of the almost empty Super Heavy booster. So, the Super Heavy booster can propulsively land using the Raptor engines, specifically targeting the launch mount where the launch tower arms can lock in below the grid fins. Apart from this general information and the occasional official SpaceX rendering of potential launch sites, nothing is known about Boca Chica's launch tower. What will it look like and how will it work? Particularly in light of the vague plans to capture Super Heavy boosters. We won't ever know until SpaceX makes it public. But don't worry, the wait won't be too long. SpaceX appears to have centered its efforts on constructing Boca Chica's first orbital launch sites, and the progress made in recent months signals that what was once a dirt apron will soon be ready to support Starship and Super Heavy testing. On March 18, 2021, the two segments of B and 1 were lined together for the first time in the high bay. According to Musk, the first booster would serve as a production pathfinder, while also assisting in the development of transportation processes from the Boca Chica build area to the launch area. SpaceX plans to launch Super Heavy and Starship into orbit as soon as July of this year. While it may appear premature as the company and its employees work around the clock on the fledgling orbital launch site, it is far from impossible that the pad will be ready for the orbital launch debut, even if Starship is not. Sounds insane, but when was the last time SpaceX ever aimed low? If you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video that is shown in the end screen. See you there.